One day, many years ago, I performed a pilgrimage to Mecca. This is a gathering in which there are millions of people from all different races and backgrounds, language groups, nationalities, all coming for this higher, noble objective to worship God. One day I was making the circumambulation, walking around the Kaaba in Mecca. Maybe it was 100 degrees outside, in a crowd of thousands of people. And I observed a family next to me. A man, a woman, maybe a child that was 12 or 13 years old. Then they had a younger child that was being carried by the father. Maybe they were 8 years old, 9 years old. And I could see the father was laboring under the weight of this child that he's carrying and trying to stay together in a crowd of thousands, knowing that if they get separated, he may not see them, I don't know, days, hours. And I looked at him and I could see that he was really suffering carrying this child, and I was about to offer my services to help him to carry the heavy child that he had on his shoulder. And then I started to think, you know, I'm a Black American. He's not from my background. We don't speak English, the same language. And we are in an environment where if we get separated, if I have malfeasance in my heart, he may not see his child. But then I thought maybe because we're in this divine place of worship that maybe we can transcend our fears and our racism. And so I moved closer to the father and I gestured to him that I'd be willing to take his child and carry that child for him. And he looked at his wife and tried to get an assessment, a read from her. Without using words, is it okay for us to give our child to this strange Black man that we don't know? And she looked at me and there was something that we communicated through our eyes. And she looked at her husband and she said, it's okay. And he reached out his hand and he passed me his child. And I put my arm in his arm. Walked around the Kaaba, praying the same God. Praying to the same God that had brought us together. He had transcended his racism and fear. And maybe for me, in the back of my mind, maybe he wasn't thinking about that I'm a Black American, that maybe I have some other kind of a hip-hop, a gangster background. He's just thinking about me through his own lens, his own concept. For me, I had to overcome my own internal racism, that he doesn't like me because I'm Black. And he has to overcome his fear of me and the unknown through his lens. And together, our faith helped us at that moment to transcend our racism and the fear of strength.